This publication contains the opinions and ideas of its author. It is intended to provide helpful, informative material on the subjects addressed in the publication. It is sold with the understanding that the author and publisher are not engaged in rendering health services in the book. The reader should consult his or her own medical and health providers as appropriate before adopting any of the suggestions in this book or drawing inferences from it. The author and publisher specifically disclaim all responsibility for any liability, loss, or risk, personal or otherwise, which is incurred as a consequence, directly or indirectly, of the use and application of any of the contents of this book. A PDF of additional material accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Atkins 100 Eating Solution, Easy Low-Carb Living for Everyday Wellness, by Colette Heimowitz. Read by Samantha Desz. Foreword, Rob Lowe. I started living my Atkins low-carb lifestyle when I was in my 30s and realized that I couldn't eat like a teenager anymore. Like many Americans, I knew I had to eat better. My health and my career depended on it. I took a hard look at what I was eating, and I started cutting back on carbohydrates and sugar. Luckily, I love all the foods that make up a low-carb lifestyle. A variety of meats, fish, and chicken, good fats, such as those in avocados, nuts, cheese, and olives, lots of colorful vegetables, and even some whole grains. I will admit that bypassing the breadbasket at dinner was tough at first, but now I don't even think about it. I noticed immediately that I had more energy and didn't get that post-lunch slump that I used to complain about. After a long day on a film set, I could go for a workout and I did not need to take a nap. In short, I just felt better. I can guess what you're thinking. Rob, you've never had a weight problem. Why do you need Atkins? That, my friends, is the reason this book was written. Atkins 100 is a low-carb, low-sugar approach that pretty much sums up the way I've been eating for years. It isn't just about losing weight. It's about your health and overall wellness. It's about preventing weight problems and, even better, avoiding long-term health issues such as type 2 diabetes. It isn't just some short-term fix you try for a few months. It's a personalized low-carb approach to eating and an accessible and livable way of looking at food and the integral part it plays in our lives. Atkins 100 is not a diet. It's a lifestyle. The author, Colette Heimowitz, has been the Atkins nutritionist for more than 25 years. She worked with Dr. Atkins in his clinical practice in New York, helping patients with a myriad of health issues, cardiovascular disease and type 2 diabetes, to name two. When it comes to low-carb eating, she knows it all, and she has devoted her life to empowering and educating people about why and how to eat this way. Because let's face it, how we feed ourselves has a powerful effect on our overall health. And if I've learned anything during these last 20 years of living Atkins' low-carb lifestyle, it's that my energy, vitality, and health have been forever changed. Now, let me be clear. I am not perfect, and I've been known to indulge in a little New York pizza and ice cream. But this is a marathon, not a sprint. This is about progress, not perfection. Everyone can do this, and you will benefit from it. If you live this way as consistently as you can, not only will you feel good now, you will feel good later and save yourself from potential future health problems. And have some fun and eat some delicious food while doing it. In this book, you will learn how to live Atkins 100's sustainable low-carb lifestyle, and even more important, understand why it's a better way to eat for a lifetime. You will find out how, with the right tips and hacks, plus the more than 50 brand new low-carb recipes, you can fill your kitchen and your plate with a rich variety of delicious, satisfying foods. Smart shopping, meal planning, and prepping will be laid out for you, and all on a budget. And you'll learn how to make the best choices when you're ordering in, dining out, or eating on the road. You will get a feel for what 100 grams of net carbs a day looks like, what it means, and how easy it can be to keep within that range. With Atkins 100, there even is the possibility of a little pizza or a taste of bread, because no food is really off limits. I believe that once you finish reading this book, you will be empowered with the tools you need to thrive and enjoy the Atkins 100 lifestyle. So here's to you and your health. I'm so glad you're here. Introduction. Carbs are the culprit. It's still happening. The standard carb-heavy American diet and outdated U.S. dietary guidelines, which recommend that 45-65% of your daily calories come from carbohydrates and only 20-35% from fat, continue to contribute to the twin epidemics of obesity and diabetes. A 2015 study published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition analyzed data from 1971 to 2011 to see which macronutrients increased during this epidemic. And it's no surprise. With carb consumption going from just below 40% of total caloric intake to 51%, carbs are the culprit. During this period, while fat intake as a percentage of calories consumed declined and protein consumption remained pretty steady, we ate more low-fiber refined carbs, which are inherently devoid of nutrients and love nothing more than to jack up blood sugar levels and store themselves as fat. Thanks to this, in the United States, 70% of adults are now considered obese or overweight. We have the distinction of being the most overweight population in the world. And the New England Journal of Medicine recently predicted that half of the U.S. population will be considered obese, not just overweight, in 10 years, with 1 in 4 severely obese, 100 pounds overweight or more. In other not-so-good news, the American Medical Association made it official in 2013 when it classified obesity as a disease. And this new disease has the potential to compromise your immune system. New research demonstrates how important building a healthy immunity is, and how avoiding unhealthy states such as obesity and type 2 diabetes can help us meet health challenges in the future. Meanwhile, 52% of the adult population has prediabetes or diabetes, an inability to regulate blood sugar, which is actually carbohydrate intolerance. Even worse, the physical and emotional effects of prediabetes and diabetes go far beyond that. This disease comes at a huge cost. If you suffer from it, you can lose your eyesight and you can lose your limbs. Potentially, it could cost you your life. The American Diabetes Association, ADA, estimated that the cost of treatment of this disease was $327 billion in 2017 and continues to rise. The good news? Emerging science continues to show the powerful and positive impact nutrition can have on your health, and people are starting to take notice. Whether you're motivated by health issues and the desire to bolster your immune system, you want to reduce your expanding waistline, or you'd just like to feel and look better, our attitudes are changing as we evolve from the low-fat, low-calorie way of eating to consciously controlling the amounts and types of carbs we eat, as shown by the popularity of the keto, low-carb Mediterranean, and paleo diets, to name just a few, all of which are low in carbs and sugar. The Low-Carb Crusade. In 1963, a cardiologist named Dr. Robert Atkins immersed himself in the study of the medical benefits of nutrition and learned that controlling carbs instead of calories led to weight loss without significant hunger. He was intrigued. So he and 65 of the executives in his private practice went on a low-carb diet. They all lost weight. Buoyed by the success of his own experience with a low-carb diet, in 1972, he published his first book, Dr. Atkins' Diet Revolution, which kicked off decades of research and debate within the medical community to determine whether a diet low in carbs and sugar was better for you than a diet low in fat and protein. And you know what? It turned out that Dr. Atkins was right. From Harvard Medical School to the American Heart Association, more than 100 scientific publications have shown the benefits of living Atkins' low-carb lifestyle, while the media, from the New York Times to the Wall Street Journal, continue to tout the benefits of low-carb eating as well. The revolution may have taken a little while to catch on, but the pendulum is swinging in the low-carb direction. It sure seems as though everyone is doing keto lately. But this and other popular diet trends, such as low-carb Mediterranean and paleo, tend to be vague in their approaches. Atkins is actually one of the original and more sustainable forms of keto, which gives you a clear-cut way to control your carbs with a wider variety of food than does a hardcore keto diet. I'll show you how later in this book. It's not surprising that low-carb variations of Atkins keep popping up. You can't go wrong when you choose whole foods that are lower in carbs and sugar. And research continues to support the science behind low-carb eating, with studies showing that beyond weight loss, a low-carb diet can dramatically reduce and even improve a variety of health problems, including prediabetes, diabetes, and cardiovascular disease. In another encouraging move, the American Diabetes Association has officially recognized a low-carb diet as a viable option for the management of diabetes. But at Atkins, we take this a step further, because we believe that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. In other words, why wait until you have diabetes, when a low-carb diet may help reduce your risk of developing prediabetes and diabetes in the first place? Introducing the Atkins 100 Eating Solution. We know that the path to wellness is not one size fits all, as shown by our current health crisis. Everyone's metabolism processes food in a different way, depending on a person's age, sex, body composition, and overall health, which is why I truly believe in personalized nutrition. When you limit your carbs and consume optimal amounts of protein, nutrient-rich vegetables and fruits, and healthy fats, you control your blood sugar. You experience steady energy levels and less hunger while losing weight or maintaining a healthy weight. How do we know this? It's based on decades of evolving, independent, peer-reviewed, published research that has consistently demonstrated improvements in health markers and wellness among people following this type of diet. In addition, decades of working with actual people have shown that Atkins' flexible, easy-to-follow approach that minimizes the consumption of sugar and processed carbs leads to a sustainable low-carb lifestyle. This is why I am excited to introduce Atkins 100 in this book. While the average American consumes approximately 240 grams of carbohydrates a day, Atkins 100 reduces your carb intake to a doable 100 grams of net carbs a day. Listen to Chapter 1 for more on net carbs. With Atkins 100, you experience many benefits of a low-carb diet, including increased energy, steady blood sugar levels, and appetite control, as well as improvements to your overall wellness, while enjoying a variety of food. How to use this book. Just as with Atkins, you can personalize this book to your needs. Start with Part 1 to learn how Atkins 20, Atkins 40, and Atkins 100 work. Skip right to the delicious new low-carb recipes in Part 3, or check out our meal plans and tips for living a low-carb lifestyle in Part 2. Part 1. I will give you an overview of the science behind Atkins, how Atkins works, the basics of carbs, protein, and fat, and how Atkins compares to other popular low-carb and low-sugar diets. Then you'll learn more about Atkins' 3 low-carb plans, getting all the information you need to determine which approach is best suited for your life. Atkins 20, Atkins 40, Atkins 100. Part 2. Now that you know how Atkins works and how Atkins 100 can be your everyday eating solution, I'll show you how to curate a low-carb kitchen as well as give you important meal planning and shopping tips. So when it's time to explore...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.